on my face, mobilizing people with an external electrode app. Edition 2. Lucid Dreams used as a monitor, also known as a recruiting app. The Air Force, called the U.S. Intelligence Collaboration App Fusion, when it's combined with Starlight Time Travel and Sculpture Mechanisms. It's the perfect NFT video game for the Air Force / Airmen cryptocurrency that is so far called the Simba Chain, and then you host Stellar Coin on it to build this NFT video game after. Anyway, once I locate the perfect Air Force run crypto, I have to find the NFT for that crypto, then throw the use of interactive NFTs like in Async Art into the Lucid Dream used as a monitor. So I'll have to take the limited interactivity of the NFT and apply that information to the Lucid Dreams user's monitor on a separate site at least, if we are unable to expand the NFT's interactivity on the Simba chain. So there's definitely an airman crypto in the same way the Air Force now buys its stuff from companies like Boeing and SpaceX, instead of making their own airplanes. You know, that's what they do. They get them from another company. So, well, I guess they build their own stuff too, but it's a good idea that the game allow you to. There is Air Force crypto mining, so the CPU power of your computer is used to mine, if you want, or is doing that automatically. You know, it's kind of like the only way to legitimize NFTs is to plug them into app/tools to create new fighter technology. So, yeah. I definitely know there's an Air Force cryptocurrency, and or an Airman's cryptocurrency. Something that's safe, you know, because Air Force dates back to the beginning of it. And I really like the idea of creating something for this to try to correct the system that's going on that is being used to, often being used to, launder money for bad guys. It's kind of awful, you know, as an artist, you make a piece of artwork, and then a bad guy buys it, launders their money with it, you get 10% or less of that money, and you know exactly where you're at when they come in. You know, that guy's gonna get his money, you know? Anyway, if you can find the perfect one for it, it's a really good idea. Because it's a type of gambling that you don't lose money at. Like, you just lose access to your money. And then you get charged a fee to get it back. I don't know. Maybe it's not gambling, though. It's like, because you're using your power to build your money and solve problems used to build Air Force technology. I don't know, I think it's the perfect way to do it. And I like combining it with using Lucid Dreams as a monitor, because you'll be mining when you're asleep. Something that looks like, it's like the Matrix actualized, you know? So like when you're asleep, you can be plugged into any system, any technology system, and your creativity, which is seriously efficiently created, it's like you just remove yourself, you know? Like compared to what it really takes to get a pattern, and that is used to solve problems. So yeah. And then, not only are you solving the problems that build the Air Force technology, but you're also experimenting with the foundation and earning more chances at having a better immortalization of your consciousness and digitization of your consciousness. You also get to participate in the defending of Earth. Literally, you get to defend Earth because the natural and basic quantum eraser experiments that allow you to sculpt with starlight that allow this time travel. The time travel through sculptures and your mechanisms throughout time to the source of that light, and allows you to travel anywhere you want to go in the universe and moves. So, at the basic level, you're able to create defensive systems of starlight structures and possibly earn actualization by U.S. intelligence to build, to have that stuff actualized, like the adjustments to the timeline, you know, defensive structures of starlight built that neutralize, you know, like, asteroids, things like that. Yeah. So. Also, you can use this to predict, like, one idea that is perfect that I'm building out is the prediction of the success of the work, you know? So, to do that, you can predict what the Webb Space Telescope is going to see. Using this game as a monitor, and quantum eraser experiments that are natural, that will hopefully gain permission to be able to see into the future. Which also, you know, the method, once you visualize it, you wander and you wake up and you sketch them 10 times. It's this thing, like creating 10 sketches and describing what you saw, you know, doing that 10 times kind of limits, like, increases your odds of actually accidentally predicting what you're going to see, because the world's kind of, you know, I have a system that I've broken down the world around us into like 25 symbols, you know, that really characterize the world around us. So we're talking about a combination of 25 symbols, like 10 times, you know. Anyway, it just seems like it's easy to accidentally name on it, but then, you know, that's kind of good shield. Anyway, that's something I'm going to use to prove the value of the medium of sculpting starlight, which has already been proven scientifically, so I just want to take it to another level. It's a pretty good idea. And so that's also the way that you can actually defend Earth on your own without being in the service, which I find fascinating. And this is another way to add to that as well. Anyway, the reason to use right now that I asked myself the question of where's the appropriate medium to apply this new genre of art and start building in, the reason to use Simba Chain is because that's Air Force, and if I'm not mistaken, I think that's Army also involved in it. But the Army hasn't put their official thing on there. They put DARPA on there, which I think DARPA is Army. But that is the cryptocurrency blockchain. And that is like the guts of the cryptocurrency. Like, that is like its house. And then the cryptocurrency that I found that was most legit, possibly, is the Stellar coin, which is made by and invented by an American. So that's good, you know. But he's not an airman, you know, he's not a soldier. So, you know, I'm still on the search for the proper coin. And maybe you don't need a coin. Maybe this image is enough on its own. And that's kind of what those NFTs do on their own anyway. It's kind of like it's its own crypto coin, from what I understand. The NFTs, so they are like it's a piece of artwork that you pay a small fee to have it on the internet, you know, like $1. Maybe it's like $5 or something. And then somebody buys it, and then it goes on this 10% paying you back, and paying you 10% of the time someone purchases it from them. You kind of, you know, so NFTs allow artists, new media artists like myself, who've always been thinking about and trying to create their own currency, to finally create their own currencies. But there isn't, it's not very clear that most of the platforms that allow you to do that can be used by bad guys. And then they have all your information because your info is stamped into your artwork, and then they track you down and stuff like that to get the money. So there's not even a tracking down that goes on. Like, they will already be up on you and take care of it that way. It's not gonna be a tracking down. They're not dumb like that. They're not gonna just randomly give you money and go look for you. So it can happen really fast. Like, you upload a piece of artwork, and then instantly, you know, some guys that were already up on you swarm you. The same guys that kind of inspired you to do it in the first place. I don't know, I mean, it's feasible. Something to look out for. But, yeah. It's the reason why. I think it's still a good thing, though, if you can figure out how to do it safely, like, with at least Americans. But even if you do it with Americans, it doesn't mean you're not doing it with drug dealers in America, you know? And I haven't really seen a reason to use a cryptocurrency until now. People are talking about artwork, you know, that's the only thing that I've seen is artwork, and then the artwork is a key. It's a system that already exists. It's just a more secure system for video games and apps and things like that. So yeah, it's a really good system, and it's finally realized. Before it was straight up, all cryptocurrency was, the only use of it was housing money for people they don't want the bank to know they have the money. You know, and people who like the idea of cryptocurrency. And so now it's the way to go for the future, like assigning rights to artwork that is a video game component, or a app component, or a tool component. For example, the Lucid Dreams uses a monitor, so literally you use Lucid Dreams when you wake up in the morning, you fall back to sleep, you use Lucid Dreams as a monitor. And so the NFT that you would add to it would be any component of that Lucid Dream. So it could be your character, for example, or the ability to create a character, or it could be the landscape, it could be be the controls that you use to participate in the lucid dream. So that's really fascinating, you know? And so while you're computing this stuff with your mind, like you're visualizing this stuff in your mind, not only are you guarding your injuries and your sleeping position, mind and your computer that you're not using to the Air Force to use to build new fighter technology, for example. I really like how it also allows you to participate in defending Earth without being in the service. It's not like eventually it'll lead to everybody is automatically in the service and defending Earth. I hope it's like that already. It's just not under wraps, so it doesn't really rain out very well. I mean, potentially it's like that already. So, but anyway, cool. So the externalized electrode app that you would, like the externalized electrode that you put into your phone, as an addition to the lucid dreams uses a monitor, that allow your brain to be scanned while it's like encouraging the use of your brain scans as a controller and extra computing power, and will lead you to having your consciousness info morph outside of the brain. So that when your brain dies, your consciousness does not die. You lose a portion of consciousness. Which is, in fact, and it's not what we talk about too much, really at all, is a complimentary thing you get from joint service. So you can also inherit it if you're trained since birth by service. But don't get hung up on that, because that's not necessarily guaranteed. There's all kinds of levels of hierarchies to which computing power comes with. And, yeah. So, definitely join the service so that you can have consciousness, externalization, / digitization. You guys know, nobody wants to die. And if you're good, you can also get on board with some really advanced, like, time travel experiments, working with time, really fast simulations. So security-wise, EtherCoin is not okay. It was invented by a Russian. So that's not very trustworthy, you know. When we're talking about trying to make things as secure as possible for an American, it's probably not a good thing to go with. Even though the British went in there with them after it was invented, it's still not a good idea. And from what I understand, and from what I saw, all the hosting sites for the NFT and the creating sites for the NFTs are all using EtherCoin, which is, I don't even know if that's how you say it, but that's not good. And yeah, none of them seem to be using the Stellar Coin, which is the American guy. So, and the Stellar Coin, if you saw that terminology, that would mean that it would have a chance of being hosted on the Simba Chain, the Simba Chain blockchain, which it has heavy Army and Air Force connections. So that would be good. But I haven't seen that yet. I'm still looking through it. I learned about it a few days ago, but I heard about it a long time ago and never really thought much about it. But now I kind of like the idea of trying to figure out a way to archive. I'm really into archival artwork, you know, and I'm into, you know, what audiences like to be at, you know, like, I think that's kind of cool. That's an audience. That's an audience. And the Air Force is the real audience. The Air Force supercomputer is the real audience. And this adds power to the Air Force supercomputer. That's really cool, you know, this idea. That's neat. So I know it's gotta exist. There's gotta be the Air Force crypto coin. It does. But it might be illegal. It might be illegal for the Air Force to have crypto coin. I don't, maybe it's not. I guess it would depend on how it's done. And hopefully I can design it in a way, if it doesn't already exist, then, you know, it really helps out. One cool aspect of cryptocurrency NFTs is that you have the option to burn them. And they kind of have an expiration on them to where they burn themselves, because unless you're doing it with the Air Force one, you know, it'll eventually probably go zero without it, like Kamikaze or something, you know? I think that's kind of interesting, because I always like to see, I don't like to destroy my artwork, but I like to see my artwork, I like to experience that too, so I think so much of it, seeing it being destroyed, kind of lets you know about how I feel about making it, really ties you to it, you know, like when you're making it, like, oh, this is not going to exist in the future, let's enjoy this, you know, kind of like how time passes, you know, this moment's going to be over soon. Anyway, money isn't really real. I mean, you know, it's just technology. And technology is such a level that it's kind of like whatever you can do to invest in, not torture and pain. You know, for example, you could literally be a homeless, legless, harmless guy and be happier than the richest guy on Earth. Especially because new screens used as a monitor, coupled with conditioning, you know, can knock you out at any moment so that you're in heaven on Earth. And then you have digitization of consciousness, eventually, so, I mean, you're gonna be that, virtually, anyway. You're gonna be, hopefully, when we get past one wind, you're gonna be in Antarctica, in an exoskeleton nest, freezing. And, you're gonna be mounted, you know, I'm still mounted by a cell phone, that constantly scans your brain, and sustains that. And you also be able to travel here virtually also. What I like to imagine, that's like drones, with like holograms, so you can interact with you. And you also are able to experience everything around in a digital way. And maybe even the robots, you know. But I think, I like the idea of the holograms. Eventually robots, they would be good too. But yeah, how is that any different, you know, than a hologram? Well, I guess we'd sensors for everything. I guess. The same sensors as a hologram, just as a hologram. Yeah. Like, I don't think you have to be a robot, you just be a hologram. Which is basically just, a lot of times, inflatable piece of plastic that you have sensors set up on. So, it's probably the same. Yeah, so I'm thinking, definitely, a hologram is the same as a robot. With all my sensors, cameras, viewing, what happens. Yeah. Thing to kind of stress, I think, now and in the future, and too in the future, to prevent what is probably going on, probably mind carrying, like we're carrying other people's consciousnesses through any control of our brain's consciousness. No, it's our brain space, our brain space, and we power their consciousnesses against our will. You know. Kind of interesting. Anyway, hopefully I'm able to get the Air Force Simba chain blockchain collaboration going for my idea. That'd be really cool. And yeah, the way Solar Wick goes, it's built already. And I talked to my friends about trying to make another group art show with it, so that would be cool. But the fact is, at that stage, unless it's marketed properly, it won't have the attention that the other ones do. And I'm pretty certain that all that money that's being used, all that is, a lot of it is not legit. And, yeah, so, something you gotta worry about.